Oh, dear.
All right, here goes nothing. Welcome to Oh Dear. This is, well, mostly a Red Deer podcast. We're going to talk about Alberta. We're going to talk about life in Alberta, and we're going to talk about what it's like to be, I guess, I mean, a quote-unquote adult living in Alberta. I'm Ted Emmett, here with Dustin Moore and Ryan Lund, and this is something we've wanted to do for a little bit. We have no idea how it's going to go. We're hoping good. We're thinking bad. So if we land somewhere in between, I think this is going to be a success. Our thought behind this, you know what? Podcasts pretty popular right now. Everyone really likes listening to celebrities, famous people talk. So we thought, let's take three absolute nobodies and see how many people want to listen. So Dustin, Lundy, I can't really call you Ryan, and I don't think I ever will, but thanks for doing this. And yeah, we're going to see how this thing goes.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to giving this a go. You know, I had a friend today ask if we knew what we were doing, and me and Ryan literally have no idea what we're doing. So thank goodness that you're in here and you got all the equipment for us, and we can roll from there.
My name's Ryan. I'm 5'10" and I have size 12 shoes, and I am looking forward to learning a lot from Ted.
You know what? If you need a dating video, we're going to save this clip. And I think that's like shooting fish in a barrel there, what you just did.
You told me to introduce myself, and I did.
Yeah, I guess I forgot to do that. I'm Dustin Moore. I'm 34 years old. I live in Red Deer, Alberta, in Anders neighborhood, and I'm excited.
And okay, off to a hot start. So we are outside right now. It is an absolutely beautiful day. It's been a great December, but really we wanted to do this, and with COVID ramping up, it's not necessarily, well, it's not only not a good idea, it's highly not recommended for us to, you know, be inside together. So we thought, why not enjoy this weather? Come outside, do this. We can still get it done because we're going to have a lot of free time outside of work hours the next couple months. So why not do something semi-productive? And so here we are. A little bit of background. Moved to Red Deer 5 years ago. Met Dustin. Became good friends with Dustin. Met Lund. Moved in with Lund. Lived here for almost three years now with Lundy. And haven't got kicked out yet. I think he said I got 8 more years till I'm 40. So I'm going to use every piece of that.
I said 8 more days.
Okay, well, then this needs to be a hit. Because this needs to make us some money. That wasn't the plan, but now that we've just flipped the plan on its head. So, hey, any sponsors out there, any local businesses, if you want your brand to be heard by tens of people, give us a call.
You know, you mentioned a little backstory on yourself of living with Lundy, and I met Lundy in junior high, grade 7, and we weren't super good friends, more colleagues, or not colleagues. what's the word I'm looking for?
Yeah, no, colleagues.
Classmates.
Colleagues makes sense.
Yeah.
We were working in grade 7.
Yeah, we're working on projects. So, yeah. You know, we really didn't become good friends until after high school. And I think mostly because he won a number of Athlete of the Years. And I think I was more jealous than anything.
And when I heard Lund won Athlete of the Year, I honestly was convinced you were homeschooled. And you, in fact, were not. So congratulations.
Yeah, no, I went to a regular school with regular people. And and kicked butt. And then I took a few years off. And I decided I'm going to get in shape starting tomorrow. So
New Year's resolution.
No, I'm going to do it as like a December 7th resolution.
Well, I was going to say, until you said the date, tomorrow can be the day after whoever listens to this. So really, you're off, like you keep yourself off the hook. Maybe I'll edit that out. We'll see how generous I'm feeling.
Yeah, I won't date us anymore. It's 2021.
Now we've got this thing going. I wanted, you know, instead of us going around the circle, keep going, you know, hey, tell everyone three things about yourself. I'm going to tell everyone three things about Lundy. Lundy's going to tell everyone three things about Dustin. Dustin's going to tell everyone three things about me. This could be a disaster. Ryan Lund, not a great cook. That's one thing. We'll get into that a little bit later. Pretty nice guy. Puts up with a grown-ass man living in his basement and maybe sometimes intruding in his life. And he's a pretty successful guy. Works for a bank. Really has a lot of people's financial lives in his hands. And I think, especially seeing him work from home, does a great job.
Well, thanks, I think, Ted.
That was like a compliment,
yeah,
sandwich.
Really was.
Well, it's lunchtime.
It's always lunchtime for you, buddy. Okay, yeah, I guess what Ted said was half true and half fake. I'll try and do the same thing for Dustin. Dustin has the biggest head I've ever seen. I don't think most hats fit him properly. Dustin's also the most connected guy in Red Deer that I know.
Unofficial mayor of Red Deer. He's been called a lot.
I think it's because he texts everyone a good 3 to 4 times a day. So hopefully he has a good phone plan. And he's also married to an amazing woman who keeps him in line.
Those are three truths. I appreciate that. So I guess I'm moving on to Ted here. Ted Emmett, born and raised in Calgary. It's in worked in a couple small towns around Calgary, High River, I believe, and Black Diamond?
Okotoks. Close enough, yeah.
Same thing. And moved to Red Deer over 5 years ago. Has a degree or diploma in communications from SATE. Am I close?
Got a radio diploma.
Radio diploma.
Yeah, that's a big brag for Ted.
So he's our radio guy that's helping start this thing. And the third one, Ted's recently kicked it into high gear at the gym and has lost, I believe, 50 pounds. So huge props to Ted and his group that's been going and pushing each other. And I mean, it's awesome to see from my side. I'm a little sad that he's skinnier than I am now, but I'm learning to live with it and have since jumped on the treadmill.
If it makes you feel any better, I'm still pretty terrible on the inside, and that's what counts, right? So beauty is only skin deep.
I don't have anything nice to say.
That's all right. I'll come up with a third nice thing to say about you later.
Okay, thanks.
All right. Well, enough about three guys that no one really cares about. Let's get this thing going. As we talked about earlier, we just want to do something for us, a little passion project, but talk about Red Deer, highlight Red Deer. You know, I've been here 5 years. I absolutely love it. Honestly, can't see myself going back to Calgary ever. You guys born and raised, live most of your lives here pretty much except for school and a little bit of hockey for Dustin. So we want to showcase Red Deer. We want to talk about it. So first thing, again, we're outside here. We're trying to follow the rules as best we can. It's going to be an interesting couple months now. We're just into the Red Deer mask bylaws. A couple days into it, people not wearing their masks. A lot of it probably just you're not thinking about it. But what do we think about this mask bylaw? I know there's two opposing sides to this. We won't get too much into it. And I'll just start by saying I think it's automatic right now. I think it's, you know what? Some people are upset. We got the anti-maskers, people marching downtown because they got to wear a mask now when they go into the gas station to buy their menthol cigarettes and scratch lottery tickets. I honestly say, like, too bad. You know, I get it. There's health issues and stuff, but for the people who are complaining just to complain, I think it's more important to keep people safe right now.
Yeah, honestly, I was kind of excited when the mask bylaw got passed, I believe, a couple weeks ago. You know, I was one of those guys who felt a little bit awkward wearing the mask when not everyone was, and I don't even know why I was feeling that way, but I was. So I was excited to kind of, I guess, fit in and not feel as peer pressured into doing it. And, you know, honestly, the person or the people I feel the most bad for right now are, you know, the people at retail stores that are working the front lines at the front, handing out masks and hand sanitizers. You know, those are usually 16 to 20 year old, you know, kid, and sometimes being berated by people that do not want to wear a mask. And I just say that if that's the case, you know, you don't need to go in that store if you're that against it. There's online shopping and stuff you can do.
Yeah. And when we talk about anti-maskers, we're talking about the people who are bringing their young children downtown to march and not the people who disagree with the bylaw. Because I think you have every right to disagree with the bylaw, but we may have just lost the anti-masker audience, which is, I mean, we probably have zero right now listening anyways, other than Dustin, who's definitely listened to this for the fourth time.
So we're trying to get as many followers as we can. So if you guys hate masks, but you love listening to us, don't let that ruin. Oh, hey, Blake. That's just my neighbor, Blake. He's a stand-up guy. Yeah, we're suntanning. We're getting interviewed by CTV News. Yeah. Yeah, right.
So there's there's a prick about Red Deer. You have great neighbors.
Oh, they said there's the prick in Red Deer.
No, that's the guy who kept me running. That's the guy who helped me lose all this weight is Stride Physiotherapy. When you got a lot of weight, it's a lot of pressure on your shins and they kept me going.
Well, I hope your shins are okay. So anyway, like I was saying, we don't want to lose any potential viewers, but if you guys hate masks or are opposed to it, that's fine. Just keep it to yourselves. And if you're out in doing the anti-mask rallies, then, I mean, you're probably going to get sick anyway, so... So I guess we don't have to worry about you. So I hope I made it clear. I'm against COVID and for masks.
Yeah, and I think we're all wondering where you stood on COVID, if you were pro or anti-COVID.
I'm anti-COVID.
So I'm glad we settled that.
Yeah.
And you know what? People talk about being forced to wear a mask is a human rights violation, and I can kind of see that side of it.
Hey, Jen.
Hi, Jen.
Oh, hi. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good.
Secret. You'll see in 2 weeks.
No, she won't.
There's again... recording outside, get to say hi to the neighbors. That's part of it. And you know what? That just goes to show that people like us because they stop to talk to us.
That looked like it was forced.
Yeah. A little bit back. Now back to the mask.
It's really easy. It's just one tiny piece of cloth. and then you can remove it when you're in your car or in your own home. Like, it takes 2 seconds. You can get free masks. And for people that say they can't breathe with it, I mean, I'm sure most people are using that as an excuse. Ted, if you touch my microphone one more time, I'm going to lose it.
Well, be better.
I hope you listen to this playback right now and you realize that you can hear me fine. So anyway, wear a mask.
And you know what? For a guy like me...
Yeah, not so funny when the shoe's on the other foot, is it, Ted?
Oh, man, this podcast is going to go great, and we're for sure going to be friends by the end of this still.
Start looking for a new place.
Well, I think the benefit of a mask, you know, coming from a guy who's probably moderate to average looking at best, but has a dazzling personality, I'm okay with the mask. I got nice, kind eyes. You know what? I can wear a mask when I go in the grocery store. And really, at the end of the day, too, we're supposed to stay home as much as possible. So the amount you're wearing a mask should be to an absolute minimum.
That's true. If you're a girl, you probably won't have to put makeup on this half of your face. If you're a guy, you probably don't have to shave that area the mask covers. So it's helping you out. It's saving you time in the morning. But it's like the same thing as wearing a hat. Do you do your hair when you wear a hat? No. So you don't have to. Look at Dustin right now. Guy didn't do his hair this morning. Full disclosure, I didn't do my hair either.
At least you dressed nice. Like, you look great.
Thanks. Yeah. It's the first nice thing you said about me today.
So I think since we started off with such a nice uplifting subject, that's good.
Why the hell did we start with this?
That's our real talk. We got the real talk out of the way. When we are talking about COVID, though, I think now we're almost a year into it, right? We look back to March. I think it sucks. We won't ever say otherwise. But I think we've seen, you know, through adversity, a lot of change, a lot of positive change happen. And what have you seen, even around Red Deer specifically? You know, a lot of businesses have pivoted. People are getting outside more. We are, you know, the virtual hangouts and stuff are happening at the expense of our liver sometimes. But what kind of positives have you seen come out of this? Just not from COVID specifically, but that everyone's kind of had to take a bit of a look inward and change the way they live their lives a little bit.
For the most part, I think most people have become more patient. It definitely takes a bit more time to get things done. I know myself working from home, and a lot of people are working from home or doing things a little bit differently. So most of the people out there are pretty understanding, which is good to see. You're always going to have those people that just like to complain and cause a ruckus, but those are a few and far between. So for me, that's something I'm happy to see and proud of people of Red Deer for taking it in stride.
And I read between the lines a little bit there when you talk about working from home, is you're excited about all the extra time you and I get to spend together.
I was excited to work from home initially. And then after about a week working from home, I realized you're not really working from home. You're living at work. So there's no real difference between the end of your day or like the work day and the weekend. Because my office is in my living room or my kitchen or wherever I feel like working that day.
My office is in the kitchen too, but I think we're talking about two different things. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Your office, your living room, your bedroom, all in the kitchen.
You know, Lenny, you talk about patience, and you know, I was pretty fortunate. The first, I guess, pause, or you know, I'm talking sports a little bit, but in March when everything kind of went on pause and in lockdown, and I happened to be on paternity leave at that time. Got a little 1-year-old daughter at that time. Well, I guess she's 1.5 now, and I took a 6-month, or I guess an 8-month paternity leave, and COVID, it was hard at first to adjust because you didn't have the play date. And you couldn't go to the swimming pool, you couldn't go to the mall and get a Starbucks and just walk around with your kid. It was a lot of at-home play.
Wait, back out. Is that a plug for Starbucks?
No.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Well, it could be.
Yeah. We'll accept our free Starbucks at any time.
But it causes you to adjust and adapt to, you know, different scenarios that everyone's living in here. You guys mentioned your family in your house here and how that living situation's changed. I think you guys fight more, but it's almost like you guys are a married couple.
We're common law at this point. But you know what? I will say honestly, because there's a lot of people that live alone out there. I can't speak for Lund because I'm probably a pretty irritating person. But it's pretty good a lot of nights, especially a Friday, Saturday night, just to be able to walk upstairs, have someone to chat with for a bit, right? Like, go down, we can enjoy our personal space anytime we want. But I think if I was living alone, it probably would have been a lot harder for that 3-4 months there initially.
Well, yeah, you talk about living alone, like the senior homes and the nursing homes. My grandma just turned 94, her 94th birthday, was unable to see, I think she's allowed 2 people and obviously her two daughters. And my dad's not on the list right now, so he can't see her either right now. It's sad. And you always wonder about the mental health of those people who are living at home. And obviously, you know, in a pandemic, it's scary both ways.
Yeah, those healthcare professionals are just miracle workers, and they should be getting paid a lot more than they currently are. Because I've got my grandma's in a long care facility too. And without those people, I'd be worried for her, but she said they've treated her great, and she's in a good mood every day. So I know if she was all alone by herself, that wouldn't be the case.
So I think seeing that and being able to recognize people, again, we focus so much on the negative, which we brilliantly did right off the top of this show, but there are some amazing people out there, and we really get to see that. And I think just seeing, for me, what's been really cool is seeing people pivot. Dustin, anyone who knows you knows that you're Mr. Organizer. You're the party planner. You guys, I joined into a huge group of friends, and I really feel like a lot of the reason that group is so close is because you plan everything. So you started doing Zoom poker nights online and playing games online right through Zoom, and Lund and I were lucky enough to be part of those couple nights by default. But doing stuff like that, right? Or even right now, we wanted to do this podcast. We talked about it. We were excited to do it. Then the new restrictions came down, and we thought, okay, it'd be pretty irresponsible to have, you know, even Dustin come over, whoever. So we did it outside. People were running a lot more. I know, you know, I ran a 5K and a 10K this summer, humble brag, but the only reason I was able to do that is because in March and April, we started running outside all the time because there was nothing else to do. Then you get to discover a whole new piece of Red Deer too. So I think in pivoting, people have really discovered a lot of things about themselves. Like, you've discovered that you're probably even worse at poker than you thought.
That's true. And, you know, Ted, you talk about pivoting and people pivoting. How about businesses, and not only Red Deer, Alberta, but, you know, some of the local businesses, you know, that we know that have some friends running in Bose, Famoso, like doing subscription packs now at home, cook at home, you know, selling some of their stuff, and they've really adapted and done well, I believe, for themselves and building their brand during COVID.
And that's just the importance of supporting local, right? Always important. I think we've seen that. And again, that's another reason why I like Red Deer so much, is living in Calgary, everything's so spread out. You don't really get the opportunity to get to know as many people who run these businesses. And basically just straight through knowing Dustin, I've got the opportunity to really meet a lot of these business owners and the people who keep small business going in Red Deer. And it's really amazing to see that. And people really are supporting local in a big way. And you know what? I can say it's a good excuse to go get a pizza or go have a chicken sandwich. You know, calories don't count when you're supporting local. So
yeah, Ange, I believe it's Ange Hall now. We knew her as Ange Kozlowski in school, but she's a local business owner, farmer. I believe they have a flower business as well. She started a pretty cool initiative this year with supporting local, and check it out on, you know, I don't have full details, but check it out on social media. And I believe it had something to do with when you buy stuff from local shops this Christmas, you keep your receipt and it goes to points or draws tickets to win a prize they're putting up. So kind of a cool initiative. You know, you kind of wonder as you think about when stuff like this comes out, why you never did it before, but it's the convenience factor of just going online on Amazon or Walmart and, you know, the big box stores to just get it delivered to your house. But in reality, we should be supporting these small local businesses more.
Speaking of local businesses, have you guys checked out that new farmer's market on Gasoline Alley? That place is amazing. I think there's 50 or 60 stores, brand new building, all local businesses from Central Alberta here. Obviously, a lot of fresh produce there, coffee, a lot of breweries are in there, and a few other stores. Although it's indoors, it's fairly spread out. But if you don't want to check it out now, maybe wait till things kind of relax a little bit. And I'd highly recommend going. I had a good time there.
Yeah, you talk about relaxing and a finish line, so to say, with vaccines on the horizon. And, you know, you just wonder what it's going to be like and how long it's going to take to get back to normal, like, and just hugging your friends and giving high fives. And the one thing I miss the most is just going out and supporting the local businesses with your friends and having that night out and the escape. You know, you hope that, you know, next summer brings that. And until then, I guess support as much as you can.
Yeah, I'll always be a big proponent for supporting local, and pretty proud to see what Red Deer businesses have done, and really in Alberta and all over, but specifically in Red Deer, just because we're on the ground here and we see it. I think they've done some amazing things.
Yeah, Alberta too. Like you mentioned Alberta, it's cool. I saw kind of a social media blitz that happened at the start of winter that all these Calgary pubs and stuff were going to keep their patios open, and kind of made a shift to buy some patio heaters and fire pits. And I've seen quite a few Instagram stories from some friends down in Calgary that are outside on patios in December, which is crazy to think about.
Well, give our friends at Troubled Monk a shout out. I was there the other day just buying some stuff, and they've got these little, like, basically gazebos now on their patio that's somewhat weatherproof, so you can go in with members of your household. So basically Lund and I can go have a nice date and have a beer. But I think that's, again, just a cool way to pivot. Outside is safer. A lot of people feel more comfortable outside. And I think even at the beginning of November, you know, we were out there on the patio having a beer, and it's kind of a cool feeling. Don't know how long this nice weather is going to last. Hopefully a while, because it'll make things a little more bearable at least. But I think stuff like that is really cool to see. And you mentioned social media, these Instagram stories. The way social media has changed, obviously, I'm a social media guy. The things people have done, the way Bose is a good one too, right? The way they've used social media, and really all those local businesses, the way social media gets used now has changed completely, and it's pretty cool to see. So again, through the adversity, I think it's some pretty welcome change, because it does force you to really look at the way you do things as a person, as a society, and make the changes where necessary. And I think when we quote unquote go back to normal, a lot of these new normals are going to carry over and be part of that.
Speaking of the new normal, do you guys know, I saw a Save On Foods delivery truck here the other day. Are we able to order groceries online and have them delivered? Is that that's a thing now?
That is a real thing.
I believe, was that before? Was that pre-COVID though? I feel like it was something that some places offered already, but I could be wrong.
Sometimes I just hate going to the grocery store.
That's me every time.
I would, like, sometimes it's okay, but I would way rather just pay someone $5 or $10 just to bring me my food.
I don't think you were their target market. I think the target market is it's a safety thing now, but
yeah, I know,
you know, maybe new mothers, things like that, people who don't have the time to go. But I think, you know, they probably saw people like you coming a mile away.
Well, then I was their target market if they saw me coming a mile away.
Yeah, my argument kind of collapsed on itself there, but
you won and lost.
You're a secondary market. You were a benefit of their original.
Oh, so my money's no good. I get it. No, my money's just as good as the 80-year-old senior that can't go to the supermarket. Just because I don't want to go to the supermarket doesn't mean I shouldn't be able to use that service.
And right now, I will say too, I'm just going to bury myself even further. You're being responsible by staying home.
It's true. So would you call me a hero for ordering groceries online?
I would not.
Would you use that word? I'm pretty sure the premier and the prime minister have called me a hero multiple times for laying on my couch. They were speaking to me directly. I know it, because I was laying on my couch and he said, "All you couch potatoes, you're a hero." And I said, "You're welcome, Mr. Prime Minister."
I believe it's Premier.
No, the Prime Minister said it too.
Oh, Justin did say
that. If laying on the couch makes you a hero, then you are basically a Greek god. Like, you are a mythical level of hero.
No, mythical is made up. I'm a real person, and I was actually laying on the couch. I think hero or inspiration are two of the words I would use to describe myself.
You know, shifting back to the grocery store conversation.
Are you going
to
do it?
Well, you know, sometimes Ashley's usually our grocery shopper.
You're
going to
do it.
I am going tomorrow grocery shopping.
Good luck.
You know, you mentioned being stuck at home and stuff. That's one thing I miss pre-COVID, is I hate grocery shopping, but I would take my daughter to the grocery store, and she would walk around and just look at everything and just see all these colors. And she was younger at the time, but
that's why I like going with Lund. When I push him in the cart, he has such a good time. All the bright colors and the fun cereals we can pick out for him. Yeah.
It was just nice to get out, and it was something to do.
That's so sad.
Pre-COVID. Yeah, it's sad. That's so sad. It was a fun adventure for our family to go to, and it's one thing I do miss, sadly.
So speaking of something to do, when it gets cold outside and we're no longer able to be out on the deck, or if it gets any worse out there, like, what are you guys going to do this winter? Like, what are your ideas to stay, not active, but to stay sane in a responsible way?
I think Ted mentioned it earlier on, organize Zoom calls, Google Meet calls with your friends. There's so many options out there of games to play with family and friends. There's the virtual bingos, there's poker, there's Taboo, there's Quiplash. Like, you go on and on about these games that you can play with your friends and family. It's 2 hours. You have a wine, a couple beers.
Or you don't have to drink. It's not a must. It just makes everything better.
Including on it. Well, I'm not going to tell anyone what to do, and I'm not going to condone drinking, but might make this podcast better to listen to.
Yeah, I'll condone drinking.
Okay. There we go. Anti-COVID, pro-drinking.
Pro-drinking.
If for those of you keeping score at home. Yeah.
Yeah, that's me.
So that kind of shifts perfectly into, we're talking about things to do during COVID. I think we've all found some great stuff. I don't think it's a secret to go out and go for a walk. You know, for me, like I said, I had some good inspiration, good support to do it, but started running outside. You know, Lund hits the treadmill in the basement. You've started hitting the treadmill in the basement. There are all those things
I just get my baseball bat and just start hitting that thing. Yeah.
With the treadmill?
Yeah.
That's your coat rack.
Yeah.
But really, you know, there's so much to do. And I think it's an opportunity, you mentioned, when it gets cold, instead of sitting and going insane at home and being mad that you can't do stuff. I think, you got to remember there's something bigger going on. So, you know, if you want to be a hero like Lund, stay on your couch. But I think get outside, go for a walk, bundle up, you know, go do something like that. There's lots of great paths to walk in Red Deer.
Hot take right here. I don't know if it's true or not, but like Red Deer's got one of the best path systems.
Absolutely.
For a city in Alberta. Hot take.
I don't know. That's it.
I think a hot take is a lot of people, like a hot take was when Lund called himself a hero.
No, that's not a hot take. That's a fact. Where do you guys go sledding or tobogganing?
You know, there's a great hill in Anders. There's a couple in Morris Row. I'm just thinking back to my childhood. Michener Hill was one that was always fun to go down. Yeah. Steep. There's always the danger of those cars being a little close to the hill though.
Oh, you're talking from the top. Oh yeah, that's dangerous.
I believe that's where the cemetery is, kind of back there.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's I for sure got a concussion back.
Yeah,
back
the zombies the don't get you, then the car as well. So be careful out there, especially with a 1-year-old.
But you do see a lot of kids wearing helmets nowadays sledding, which is good. The facts and the information's out there on concussions, and it seems that people are a little safer these days.
I have had one concussion from sledding. Yeah, so like it happens.
I've probably cried a number of times from hitting my head or hitting a tree sledding. So I probably should have worn
it. It was a rough day for you yesterday. Yeah. But yeah.
What's your favorite hill?
Yeah, like Michener's the one I remember. There was also one out in the county. Like if you're on 19th Street, if you head south for about 10 minutes, I don't know exactly where it is, but we went out there as kids, and it was just a big secluded hill in the middle of nowhere. That was probably my favorite one. I can't pinpoint it or anything, but... yeah, that was awesome because went out with a buddy. His dad brought us out. We'd go down, then his dad would drive us up in the truck, so we didn't have to walk back up the hill, which is probably why.
Athlete of the year, ladies and gentlemen.
I
don't want to go buy groceries because I've got to get 600 steps going through the grocery store.
600? You can do grocery stepping. You do grocery shopping in 600 steps?
Well, I don't know. I've never kept track because I don't care. It takes as many steps as it takes.
Apparently, you have kept track. 600 seems pretty specific. I'm sorry for helping out the society and not going out there exposing them to me and me to them.
To COVID. Make sure you add to like exposing them to COVID at the end of that sentence. That's fair. Yeah.
Did you have a Brett Hall GT racer?
Well, the sniper, yeah.
The sniper and get the poster?
No.
I had a
GT, but no, I don't think I had the Brett Hall.
They need to bring that back. That would be retro. I would think about it as a 34-year-old guy buying it.
I thought they outlawed GTs. I thought they were too dangerous.
Yeah, we used to take the brakes off of them. So like when you go off jumps and stuff, you could get more air. And we used to, like in high school on the weekends and stuff, we would go and build huge jumps. And man, like we put a strain on our healthcare system, I think, whenever we went sledding, because we were not safe. So be safe out there. Wear a helmet. So you talk about hills. I know one of Dustin's favorite hills is One Tree Hill. The really cold days, you want to talk about something to do. It took you a second, didn't it?
I was just laughing at how bad that joke was.
It still made you laugh.
Oh, it was like awkward silence after you said it, and I didn't want to say anything.
It wasn't silence. I was still talking.
Oh,
Chad Michael Murray. Yeah.
But really,
Dreamboat.
When we're talking about things to do when it's really cold out, man, you know, the streaming services, obviously, were already very popular, but now have really come out. So what are you binging?
Oh, I was going to answer a completely different question.
All right, answer your own question first.
No, you asked it. I'll play by your rules and answer your silly question. At the moment, I did start Schitt's Creek. I never really got into it. Then it won all the awards, and then some people recently watched it and said it's actually not bad. And I agree. I'm getting into it. So I think I'm on season 2 or 3 right now. Just finished watching The Boys, which is like...
It's the other end of the spectrum from Schitt's Creek.
Yeah.
Schitt's Creek's very wholesome, and The Boys is like way
very,
out there.
Very gory, and it's like what happens if superheroes go bad. So that I really like that show. Yeah, and oh, I watched The Queen's Gambit on Netflix. I played chess as a kid and haven't played it in about 10 years. And yeah, started playing chess on my phone because it's easy to do online. And while I'm sitting on the couch being a hero, it's something to do.
Not surprised to hear that because you're actually, here's a nice thing for the very top of the show. Ryan Lund is a very smart man, but I didn't know that.
Why didn't you lead with that?
I was nervous. I got put on the. I panicked and made fun of your cooking skills.
Yeah, that's...
But when you talk about Schitt's Creek, and I started watching it. Same thing after the awards and stuff. And I don't know why I never watched it because Eugene Levy is a national treasure. But it's just such an interesting show because it is quite wholesome. But what I've noticed about it now is, you know, the way they wrote the show, Dan and Eugene Levy, is in the town, no one's homophobic, no one's racist, right? Like, everyone just loves everyone for who they are. And a lot of shows, while they tackle those issues, this is basically a world where none of that even exists. So it's pretty cool to see. And I think that show means a lot to a lot of people for those type of reasons. So that is one. Again, Lund and I both hopped on the bandwagon because of the award show, and it got really popular on Netflix, but highly recommend that one. Dustin, I know you watch a lot of cartoons, and then you watch even more with Bryn now that you have a daughter. But what about you? What's your number one recommendation right now?
Well, we have watched a lot of The Wiggles. They drive me insane. I'm sure most parents, if any parents are listening right now, will agree with me.
Do The Wiggles have any bangers?
Yeah.
Waffles in the morning.
Hot potato. Yeah. There's some good ones. They're addicting, I'll be honest. Like, we got it on all the time in
the
car.
Are The Wiggles like the new Teletubbies?
They've been around a while, but they're...
Yeah, I think they're out of Australia or New Zealand or, you know, on that side of the world anyways. And yeah, I don't know what it is. Like, I think maybe just the music, but yeah, Bryn loves it. I try to get her into Paw Patrol and she won't dabble in that. So, but myself, I'm a big reality show guy, but so I love when that stuff's on. Amazing Race is on right now. But me and my wife just started getting into Better Call Saul. My favorite show, Breaking Bad. I thought it was an amazing show. If you haven't watched it, you got to watch it. My dad just had surgery. He went through it in, I think there's five seasons. He went through five seasons in like a week. Like, it's amazing. But Better Call Saul. And then I most recently got into Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Ted's been pushing me on Brooklyn Nine-Nine for about 5 years. So just started. I think I'm on episode 6. Pretty funny show. So that's one I'm watching right now.
People make fun of me for it. Well, hey, I just crushed Gossip Girl, which, you know, a lot of people like it. And they say, oh, I was into it, but I wasn't into it like as a, you know, young adult, like most people. As a 32-year-old man, I made the conscious choice to watch Gossip Girl. And it was, I don't even know if I liked it, but it pulled me in. And I didn't like the type of person I was when I was watching it because I was cheering for the drama. Those kids, they trade partners more than square dancers. And it is crazy. But it's, I highly recommend Gossip Girl if you're really looking to shut your brain off and watch something that's pretty terrible. But I think most people have seen it. So I was way behind on that one. And I'm the world's biggest advocate for Golden Girls. That show is absolutely timeless. I know Lund, every day I try to get Lund to watch Golden Girls, and maybe one day it'll happen. Maybe if we could start a social media campaign to get Lund to watch the Golden Girls. But people hear Golden Girls, right? It's four elderly women living together, not necessarily something they think is something they're going to enjoy, but it is hilarious. It is. I mean, who doesn't want to spend every night in bed with four experienced women, right? So Amazon Prime Video, that's where they are. Highly recommend it. I just convinced a 27-year-old man to watch it, and he enjoys it quite a bit. So give it a go.
Let's fast forward 30 years from now, and you and Lundy buy a new house. You could probably do Golden Boys.
Well, number one, we wouldn't call it that. Number two, Dad's got 8 days to move out. So I thought we made that clear off the top.
8 days from when someone listens to this podcast. So it could go.
Yeah, we'll see how long it takes Ted to edit this thing.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. This may never make it to the internet.
COVID's going to be a thing of the past, like a historical thing by the time this thing airs.
And by the time I move out.
Teddy, you mentioned Gossip Girl. Like, you're taking us back to when we were, 18 when that came out, Lundy? Like, that wasn't even the best show at the time. Like, One Tree Hill, The O.C. Like,
first
are you kidding
season
me?
Of The O.C., yeah.
Oh, man. Like, I remember getting together, playing junior hockey in Olds, and then in Red Deer after, Thursday nights, O.C. parties. Like, we would sit there, not even have a beer. Like, we would just sit there and enjoy the show watching Marissa. Was it Marissa? and Summer. Like, oh man, that show was so bad now that you go back and watch it. But at the time, it seemed like it was the best show on TV.
Well, I remember with the OC, I remember Sandy Cohen's still my hero. And, you know, when however, I was not even 18, I was thinking, that guy needs to tweeze his eyebrows. And then you get older, right? And be careful what you say about who, because now I got the Sandy Cohen eyebrows, right? Sandy Cohen look without all the wealth and family and just friends that comes with being Sandy Cohen.
Funny you talk about Sandy Cohen and you looking like him. Your counterpart right beside you right now looks like Ryan Atwood from Chino.
Is he the main character? Yeah, I'll take that.
He was pretty hard up before he moved to the OC, and you okay. Definitely look like him. Right
you
now.
Do look like you prepared for this podcast by drinking whiskey for 72 hours straight.
Well, I'm pretty sure that'd be impossible. Number two, we're outside and wearing a jacket to stay warm. I'm pretty sure I don't want to catch a cold, especially during these times. I think I'm the only responsible one here. Number three, it's comfy. It's a comfy jacket.
It's just, I just want to say, you know, we thought we'd wear Christmas sweaters because it's December. Be festive, but Scrooge McLund over here just absolutely refused, even though he looks wonderful in a Christmas sweater.
Didn't you guys hear Christmas was canceled this year?
I just think he's not super thrilled that we're doing this on a Sunday afternoon when NFL football is on.
Who the heck decided Sunday afternoon was a good time to record? Who the heck decided Sunday afternoon is a good time to do anything, for that matter?
Yeah, I mean, you're playing for first place in our fantasy pool.
We're
today
missing
too.
Some football. Like, that's the other thing. We can't, like, it's weird not watching hockey this time of year. So I've really gotten into football. It's like the one day a week.
What do you mean?
The 5 days a week you can watch football.
Tuesday
now.
Night football. Yeah, Wednesday night football.
Yeah, what about Wednesday afternoon football? That was nice. You know, now we're talking about live TV. Tell you one thing, and you can't blame anyone, but obviously harder to make commercials. You're seeing the same ones over and over again, and the ones that are on there are terrible. Like, I will take a shot at CTV. They need some new commercials. Like, how many times did we have to see that one clip for that Be Positive show where that girl just yells, "Exactly!" for 3 minutes of commercial, every commercial break. Like, there are some terrible commercials out there, and I could talk for 3 hours about the bad commercials out there. Questrade, you need a new commercial.
I don't know if I, on the spot, could think of a commercial right now. Like, besides streaming services, when I'm watching live TV, it seems like, I guess when a commercial comes, when there's a stoppage of play at sports or something, I'm on my phone looking at Instagram and Twitter, and it's probably not a good thing because I need to get off that a little bit. But yeah, I couldn't think of a commercial right now.
Oh, the Questrade one, and Lund knows what I'm talking. I think our favorite pastime is sitting there sometimes and yelling at commercials.
It's not our favorite pastime.
Okay, it's my favorite pastime. Whatever, thanks.
Well, you keep lumping me in with you. Like, we have all the same likes and dislikes. We're two different people. We have different interests, different hobbies.
Well, we sit there and we both make fun of commercials together. It's something we do, and don't take that away from me. But the Questrade commercial, a couple of them are bad. They're so overly dramatic, especially the one with the two brothers. And at the end, the guy goes, "You're not still using mom and dad's guy, are you?" And the look the guy gives looks like it's the brother might as well ask, like, "Do you know if that girl was 18? I could come up with probably 50 things that are more dramatic than using mom and dad's guy for investing.
Okay, do it. I think that'd be a hit.
Yeah. All right, we're gonna do it. All right, so now before we wrap things up, we thought just try something out. This might work, it might not. I think people would agree that, well, not just the three of us, but the three of us, we spend a lot of time together. Lund and I have lived together now for almost 3 years. We thought we'd see how well Lund actually knows me, how much he pays attention. So Dustin's got a little quiz for you. I don't know the questions, and I want to see what Dustin thinks are the right answers or the right answers. So here's a little segment called 10 Things I Know About Ted.
So what do I have to get? Like, if I get 3 right, is that enough?
If you get 10 right, I will move out in 8 years.
All right, Lundy, ready?
Yeah.
Question one, easy one.
Okay.
What is Ted's favorite food?
Oh, there's just so many answers. Like, is it specific or like a nationality?
This isn't a spelling bee.
I'm gonna say Chinese food.
I mean, I don't have one specific favorite, so I will accept Chinese.
Yes.
Actually, I should wait and see you say yes or no, Dustin, and I want to see if you're right too.
I would have thought pizza.
No. If I was gonna go with a specific food, it's absolutely a hot dog.
So wait, did I get it? Like, are you awarding the points?
I'm giving you a point. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Lundy. Question number two, who is Ted's favorite football team?
Oh, I do know this one. The Tennessee Titans.
Who are losing 41-7 at this point right now.
And let me just say this. Ted just has no faith in his own team. Every time that they're up, he's always talking about how they're going to blow it. And they have a good team this year. They're playing well. Not today. I guess it's not today when you air this, but...
They could be playing bad when someone's listening to this, though. It's very possible.
This is exactly what I'm talking about. So 2 for 2.
Yeah, I'll agree. Tennessee Titans. Who is Ted's favorite hockey player all time?
Oh.
Living, dead, playing, not.
Just knowing Ted, I know it's got to be someone old. It wouldn't be like a normal or common favorite player. So I'm going to say somebody like Gordie Howe.
I'm going Theo Fleury.
Those are both good guesses. Theo Fleury was my hero growing up. But the more I got to know hockey and learn about the history of hockey, is it Bobby Orr? Number one.
Okay.
Oh, wow. All right. I probably should have said Peter Marr, to be honest. You're a broadcast guy.
Yeah, that is one of the reasons I got into broadcasting. Real story there.
Okay, Lund, you didn't get that one right, but that was a tough one.
Yeah.
Question number four. What is Ted's favorite local restaurant?
This is going to burn some bridges for me.
Yeah.
Here, depending on who's listening.
I'm going to go with Bo's.
I'll say Famoso.
And I'll say... Whatever, if you're a local restaurant owner and you think that you're my favorite restaurant, you're right. Next question.
Good answer. We'll award you the points there, Lon, because it could have been right.
You know what? Bo's great food. Brennan, great person, does a lot for the community. So yeah. And Famoso, same thing there with Ryan Curtis. Two guys who do a lot for us. So we'll call both of those correct answers for sure.
Okay, Lundy, question number five. What's Ted's favorite color?
I'm going to say blue.
I'm going red.
Blue is a good guess. It's blue.
Oh, wow. I should move in.
Yeah, you and me could trade places.
All right, Lonnie, question number six. What is Ted's favorite vacation destination?
It's out east with his family in...
Well, it's Nova Scotia.
Nova Scotia.
I'll say Disneyland.
Disney World, but yes and yes. Both Disneyland.
Well,
I've only been
one.
To Disneyland once, but it is Nova Scotia is my favorite place in the whole world.
Oh. Wow. Stay hot, Lundy.
Yeah.
This guy never shuts up about his life, so I know everything about him.
This is going to be a tough one. If you get this right.
Do I win if I get this one
right?
Yeah. Okay.
Well, I guess if you get it right, we're pretty much playing match game and you guys know what to do next.
I don't want to play anymore.
Yeah. Stop the count.
What? What is Ted's favorite gas station? Where does he get his gas?
Taco Bell.
Yeah. Okay. What is it? Octane? Where did he get his octane?
Yeah. Well, yeah, it's high.
For his car.
Oh, for his car. Oh, okay. Because, yeah, he gets plenty of octane from Taco Bell. Ted's probably not that picky about the gas itself. He probably goes to a gas station with the nicest bathroom. And there was that one place.
It's on Gasoline Alley, I think, isn't it? The nicest gas.
That had the nicest bath. So I'm going to say that gas station.
I go to the Shell so I get air miles. Well, wow. Hey, surprise. Ted is a practical human being.
Well, that's such a normal answer. Wow.
Yeah, we're over here in Alex, Alberta or Timberstone, and he's going to drive to Gasoline Alley to get his gas. That is the worst answer ever.
Yeah,
I don't know. They have a nice bathroom, and I know Ted appreciates a nice bathroom.
Okay, next question. Question number 8. Who is Ted's favorite actress?
Betty White.
I'm going Jennifer Aniston.
I don't even know if I have an answer to that one. You know what? I think Betty White would be closer, though. Because she is a gem.
A spinoff. Who is Ted's actress crush?
Betty White.
Okay, I'm going Jennifer Aniston again.
Jennifer Aniston for a long time for sure. I think the correct answer though would be the Pink Power Ranger because I'm only human. Not now, but like when I was a kid. Now it would be a little weird.
Like mask on?
Yeah, her name was...
Doesn't matter.
Mask on. Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Could you?
You know what? Growing up, I probably imagined that a lot. I'm not going to lie.
Question number 9. What is Ted's favorite song all time?
All time's tough. It's a boy band. It's got to be Backstreet Boys. I want it that way.
I'm going to go... Ted used to work at a few radio stations, so he's got me and Lund beat on the cultured piece in music. I'm going to go old time rock, Guns N' Roses... AC/DC.
You can't keep nodding and giving me hints.
I'll say Prince Kiss.
Oh, that's a great song. Great guess, Lund. But fun fact, I Want It That Way is not even my favorite Backstreet Boys song. So we'll leave that for, if we ever get to episode 2. But Gimme Shelter, Rolling Stones. At least in my opinion, just the most perfect song ever made.
Never heard of it.
Me neither. You're on a streak right now of 1, 2, 3 in a row wrong. So let's finish strong. Question number 10, a little bit of an easier one because there's not many options. But which is Ted's favorite local golf course? And by local, let's do a 30-minute diameter?
No.
Radius. Yeah, trigonometry wasn't my algebra. Trigonometry, that was my strong suit.
So I'm going to rule out the Red Deer Golf and Country Club there because I don't think Ted's broke 100 playing there in a long time.
Just my spirit. That's the only thing that gets broken.
Yeah, so I guarantee you it's not going to be that one. Because I know you guys go to Sylvan a bit. Oh, this is a tough one because
I go where the deal's at.
Yeah, I know that. That's exactly what I'm saying. Like, he's going to go where he gets free golf or wherever someone takes him. But assuming they're all free or all the same price, I'll just say Riverbend.
Okay, I was going to say Riverbend too, but I'll go Alberta Springs just to be different.
I do like Riverbend. I mean, obviously, it's a 2-minute drive from here, but I like Riverbend. I like the golf course. The mini links is an absolute, like, if you're listening, you have kids or not, like, in the summer, go down and play that mini links. It's great practice. It's a lot of fun. We go down there, play skins games, and go down there to run or walk the path. So Riverbend is the total package in what I'm looking for in outdoor recreation.
Well, at least you finished strong, Lundy.
So what I got, 6 right? 7 right?
I think you were about 6, yeah.
But all the ones that got wrong were, like, Ted didn't even have answers for those ones either. So.
Yeah, those were those were harder questions than I thought. I thought you were going to ask like pretty specific, but I learned something about myself and that's all you can ask.
I came up with these questions on the way over and just, as you can see, saw a gas station and saw a pizza place.
What's Ted's favorite turn signal? The left turn signal or the right turn signal? All right. So you did pretty good on that quiz. And I'm going to say it's 50% that you actually pay attention and probably like 80% that I never shut up. But now that you're warmed up for a quiz, we're going to go we're going to start a Dustin versus Lund competition. And you know what? You guys might be lucky if we never get past episode 1. Every episode, I'm going to give some sort of quiz to you guys, right? And then the first person to 5 wins the bet. And Dustin, what did you and Lund decide on in your bet? So this is going to be an ongoing thing. Could be, it's basically a best of 9. So we better do at least 9 episodes. What did you guys decide on the loser has to do in this bet?
Well, anyone who knows Lund or has been swimming with him knows that his chest hair is shaped like the bat signal, like from Batman. So we decided that we're going to go the first to 5 wins. The other guy, she asked to wax their chest at a local establishment.
So I when he says we decided, that's a lie. I heard about this 10 minutes prior to the filming. And Dustin's already waxing his legs this year, so I feel like he's already in it no matter what. I'll do it. I'll wax my chest, but I feel like Dustin has to do a little bit more because he doesn't have nearly as much hair as I do.
I'll go chest and back.
Do you have any hair on your back?
That remains to be seen.
Yeah, how would he know? He can't see it. All right, so loser of Dustin versus Lund has to get their chest waxed. Dustin versus Lund, round 1. We're going to play a game called Alberta Man or Florida Man. So basically, I took 10 headlines that I've found, and you got to fill in the blank if the word is Alberta or Florida. Number 1, blank man attacked during selfie with squirrel.
Alberta.
Florida man attacked during selfie with squirrel. I knew that one. A little trick question.
I didn't even know there were squirrels in Florida.
This one, you might know this one.
Well, yeah, we got 50% chance.
Blank man flies over city in balloon-driven lawn chair.
Alberta man.
Lawn chair. There's a lot of lawn chairs in Florida.
That is what they're known for. It's on their license plate. The lawn chair state.
I'll go with Florida.
It is Alberta. So it's 1-0 for Dustin. Lawn chair Larry. And so in 2015... Lawn chair Larry, a Calgary man, strapped $12,000 in helium-filled balloons to a $20 lawn chair and set sail over the city's stampede grounds.
I never heard about that.
So here goes number 3. Dustin's up 1-0. A blank man wears an F the police shirt to court and wins his case.
Alberta man.
I'll go with Alberta as well.
Florida man. Oh. That one. So still 1-0 for Dustin. We got 7 questions left. Another shirt one. Blank man wearing a shirt that says, "No, seriously, I have drugs." Arrested for possession of drugs.
Florida.
Alberta man.
It is a Florida man. So we have a 1-1 tie after 4 questions. Here's a fun one. Blank man robs a restaurant with a rubber chicken.
Florida.
Alberta Man.
It was an Airdrie Man in February. So this year he robbed a Tim Hortons. Man from Airdrie, Alberta stole a donation box from a Tim Hortons by hiding it behind a rubber chicken. So 2-1 for Dustin.
That's insane.
A blank man climbs a 26-story building to take an unoccupied crane for a test drive.
Florida Man. You don't want to go down too.
I know. Like, how many 26-story buildings are there in Alberta? I'll go with Florida.
Calgary has a lot of 26-story buildings. In 2016, a Calgary man climbed 340 feet, easy for me to say, up an unoccupied crane for no reason other than to take it for a test drive.
So hey, Len, quit cheating over
there. We're still 2-1. There's no way he can read this. It's not a picture.
I can read.
All right, number 7. We're still 2-1, so it's close. Blank man suspected of using a private plane to draw a giant penis on the radar tracker.
I heard about this.
I do too. I can't remember where though.
I thought it was in New York. Are you going off the board, New York or Buffalo?
I'll say Florida.
Yeah, I'll say Florida too.
Yeah, you're both right.
Yeah.
So 3-2. Blank man steals a car, realizes a baby is in it, drops baby off safely, and then makes his getaway.
I feel like this has happened in both. Like, can I just say both?
No, this is specific.
I'm going Alberta.
There's a ton of car thefts in Alberta, but Florida, there's just so many more people. I'll go with Florida.
It is Florida. So we got a tie, 3-3, two questions left. I guess I should have done a tiebreaker. Let's hope I don't get caught with my pants down on that one. Yes. Blank man shoot. Yeah, hope. For more reasons than one. Blank man shoots ceiling, robs karaoke bar, apologizes, then runs out of gas during his getaway.
That's a headline?
I paraphrased it, yeah.
He did an office pop. and then he robbed the karaoke bar that was upstairs.
No, like in the bar.
I'm letting you answer first.
Yeah, okay. I'll do Florida.
Okay, I'm going Alberta.
It is an Alberta man. It happened in Onaway in 2016. On Friday the 13th, a man walked into the Onaway hotel bar, waited for a patron to finish her cover of the Dixie Chicks, pulled a gun, fired a shot into the roof, and robbed the bar. As he was walking out the door, he turned around and said, "Sorry, guys," to everyone in the bar.
That was nice of him.
Then the getaway car, which he was driving with his 18-year-old niece, later ran out of gas, and they were arrested.
It's a rough day. Can you imagine, like, thinking you got away with it? You're probably pumped and celebrating, and then his niece had like one job to make sure to have a full tank of gas. And
should have gone to the Shell.
I was thinking Taco Bell.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Question 10. Blank man eats his own underwear to pass a breathalyzer test.
Okay, I'll choose the opposite of Dustin.
I'm going Alberta.
It is an Alberta man. It actually happened just up the highway at Stettler. In 2017, a man from Stettler, Alberta, attempted to eat a breathalyzer by eating his own underwear.
Did he do
it? According to the Red Deer Advocate, he was convinced that the cotton fabric would actually absorb alcohol.
Wait a second.
He ripped the crotch out of his shorts, stuffed the fabric in his mouth, and then spit it out.
Like, if you did that, would you admit to doing it?
Well, yeah. They probably saw him do it.
Like, I guess he didn't
No, he stuffed it in his mouth. Like, but why the crotch? Like, that's the last part, maybe the second last part of your underwear that you'd want to rip out and stuff in your mouth.
Like, did he blow with the underwear?
Okay, this wasn't me.
Well, you obviously did the research on this. Like, did he blow with the underwear still in his mouth?
No, you put it in his mouth, thought it would absorb the alcohol, and then spit it out and did the breathalyzer.
Ugh.
So that's all I know about it. All I know is, like, is Alberta the Florida?
Canada? I feel like most of those answers were Alberta, or was it?
It was half and half.
Oh, it was? I think I guessed Florida for like 7 or 8 of those.
So that's a 1-0 lead for Dustin.
Goodbye, bat signal.
Yeah, we have to find another way to call Batman when we need him now.
It'll grow back. It always does.
So that was a fun little game. Maybe more of a scathing indictment of some of the people that live in Alberta than I was hoping for. But that's pretty much almost it for Oh Dear. Hopefully that's something you didn't say too much. Really, at the end of the day, I think we had fun. Hopefully we're not too terrible. But we want to hear from the listeners. Hopefully plural when we say listeners. So we're going to have social media. Follow us. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube at Oh Dear Podcast. DEER. Obviously, if you can see what we did there. If you like that joke, thank you. And if you don't like it, Dustin came up with it. Follow us. Let us know maybe what you want to hear. If you have a Q&A, we'll do a Q&A session, an open book, or what do they call it? An AMA, an Ask Me Anything.
Oh, I've never heard that before.
You know what? Slide into our DMs. We all like DM slides. Let us know if you got a question. And here's something. We want to come up with a new segment. So we're going to have a contest. If you can come up with a good segment, slide into our DMs on Twitter, Instagram, doesn't matter. And if we pick your segment, I am going to shovel your driveway 3 times this winter.
That's not going to happen. Ted doesn't even shovel our walks.
Yeah, actually.
Edward, that's time. All right.
If you're Batman with your bat signal, I am Alfred, because I'm the only one who does any chores around this house.
See what I have to put up with? Like, every day.
But we will, and there'll be proof. Like, I'm saying this right now, and people are going to want to see proof on social media that I'm shoveling the driveway. So if you want to come up with a segment, and we like it, when we choose it, I will shovel your driveway 3 driveways. If you want to spread the love and maybe one day, like, really just make me go to work and pick 2 friends, and I go shovel their driveway, great. But that's what's out there. Again, we're all always looking for feedback, so slide into those DMs and make us feel like we're liked.
don't end like that.
Is that our sign off?
Yeah, don't end like please that. Like us.
Please don't end.
All right, though, we're gonna work on our sign off. But again, for Dustin Moore and Ryan Lund, I'm Ted Emmett. Thanks for listening, and if you made it this far, God bless you.